I love that advert.
What, just giving them away.
Okay, time for some more calls on...
What is Alan firing his friend's air rifle into?
That sound again. And again. Line 10, what am I firing my friend's air rifle into?
A sandwich.
Wrong, line 3.
The future?
Are you on an E? Line 6.
Don't know.
Did you call earlier?
Yeah, I did.
Unbelievable. Line 4.
Chop, chop, the nurse is here.
What the hell's all that about?
No idea, mate.
Seriously, what?
Might have something to do with me.
Why?
It's to do with something I did on the on Branning's show last night.
Well, let's hear it.
Move on.
No, let's hear
move
it.
Move on.
Let's hear it. Seriously.
It wouldn't work now.
You can't deprive the listeners of mid-morning matters.
On this occasion, I think I should.
Seriously, let's hear what you did.
Really? Yes?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, Carl Branning was under the weather, and he had some night nurse and some day nurse. And so the big joke was, you know, which one should he take? Because it's the night time, but he still didn't want to go to sleep. And then the callers started. It's like the later night, the callers are a bit more sort of zany. So they start calling in and with the other suggestions for nurses and people. And anyway, the point was someone called in about a mental nurse. And then I basically was then a mental nurse for the next hour, just doing a, you know, stupid character. About this nurse who kind of scuttles around the wards and is like putting milk into the drips and things, and she's just toppling people out of beds. And I don't really.
Sidekick Simon. Oh, don't worry about it. Wait a minute. Have you seen Duck Soup and Mark's
Brothers? Oh, yeah.
You'd love that. OK, time for traffic and travel.
Traffic and travel.
That was Alison Moyet again. And now for the final choice cut of Partridge on Partridge.
Sounds like two birds copulating.
Not now, mate.
What about family? Got any kids?
Yeah, I got a couple, male and female.
Names?
Denise is the female, and Fernando, he's the other one.
Love them?
Just a bit.
Do they listen to the show?
Yes, they do.
It's not what they told me.
You don't know.
What would
you
be
know
your ideal evening?
I'll tell you what it wouldn't be. Having a pint of bitter with a traitor.
Come on, Alan, give me a break.
Who said I was talking about you? World doesn't revolve around
no,
you.
No, I'm not saying that.
You're not the moon.
Yeah, I thought you said you weren't bothered.
What about your favourite TV show?
Deal or No Deal, I'm not bothered.
And why is that?
Edmonds. You know, you can do what you like for all I care. It's a free country, unless they change the law.
What about a favourite war?
100 years. I'll tell you something else.
Any reason?
Pioneering use of cannons. You can make love to the guy for all I care. You know, bum time with Branning. You know, that's been legal since 67.
What's your greatest strength?
You give a break to a lab assistant from secondary modern.
Your biggest weakness?
Repays you by taking 30 pieces of Branning's silver.
He's not paying me, Alan.
It's a metaphor.
What makes you laugh?
To recap... Key strength, courage, weakness, too kind, funny, YouTube, sneezing panda, enjoyed chat.
I enjoyed chatting to you too, thanks, Alan. And tell Chagwin I'll pay for the dry cleaning, but he should count himself lucky.
Something else. And the answer to what is Alan firing his friend's air rifle into is a beef tomato. And here is Mick Hucknall.